Joining us on the line from Bali, we have the ASEAN Secretary General himself, Sirin Pitsawan, joins us on the program this morning. And Mr. Pitsawan, what a pleasure to have you. First of all, how critical is this ASEAN summit? Because some say it could be the most critical, in fact, in many, many years.
Yes, it is extremely important because we have so many issues that we have to consider. And the fact that East Asia has become so important to the global community and ASEAN is sitting right in the middle of that growth center, it makes the region much, much more relatively important than, let's say, 10 years ago. And therefore, a lot of attention, a lot of focus have been put on what we are doing, what we are deliberating on here, and whatever they decide at the leadership level among ASEAN and with the dialogue partners, yeah, including the major and superpowers, will have implications on the region.
Mr. Pitsawan, as you speak, we're showing live pictures right now of coming from Bali, Indonesia, where the summit is taking place. World leaders are gathering.
Yes.
In fact, you have some really high-profile attendees this year, including the U.S. President himself, Barack Obama, the Chinese Premier, Wen Jiabao. So what, in your view, would make this meeting a success, considering implementation has been difficult, even with agreements in past ASEAN summits?
Well, this time, certainly the addition of Russia and the United States into the East Asia Forum is a very, very major step forward. And we believe that the two big powers can make a contribution into the economic cooperation in the region among us, and certainly issues of stability, issues of security, issues of prosperity, investment, and cooperations on many other areas. As I said, you know, this is the part of the world that seems to be doing quite well compared to the rest of the world, and the world is expecting that this is going to be a new locomotive. Therefore, yeah, any issue that would have implications on that growth, on that dynamism, will have some implications on the global community as a whole. So the world leaders are here, and the world is very much focusing on it.
Yes. Secretary General, you know, you, along with a lot of people watching these ASEAN summits, have expressed their frustration in that implementation of agreement hasn't been done in a lot of countries in the ASEAN group. So how does this, I guess, affect relevance of these meetings? Some are saying, what's the point?
Well, I mean, ASEAN has a very incremental way of doing things for the last 44 years, and we have achieved our goals and our objectives in ways that sometimes we surprise others. We are a country, an organization of tremendous diversity, but we have to manage that diversity, so the speed will have to be very comfortable to everyone. But I think the world is now recognizing, as witnessed by the attention and the participation of major superpowers, that we are doing the things right, just for our part of the world. It's not the same, but we are trying to do what we can in order to offer our region, our forum, and our stage,
yeah,
for discussion and dialogue on many, many important issues.
Secretary General, as you mentioned, lots of topics on the agenda. In terms of economics, the world's right now focusing in on Europe. How do you think Europe will affect the Southeast Asian region? Could we be in for some major declines in the future?
If anything, it has enhanced our own result, that we have to integrate more and more carefully, and we have to help each other in order to move forward and make sure that this is a region of one market integrated. But we have to be extremely careful not to have one member having problem that would have contagion effect on others. So we're not thinking about one currency, but we are certainly thinking about coordination, about helping each other, monitoring the economic health of each other, so that if anything goes in the wrong direction, we can give some advance warning. Not as tightly knit as in the European Union, but I think our instruments now are good enough to keep us on course into the future.
Mr. Pitsawan, does that mean that you're not concerned about Europe? What are your thoughts?
We are concerned about Europe, but we cannot depend on the market of Europe and North America forever. That's a clear message that we have been given, even from the European leaders, from the American leaders. So we have to build our own demand. We have to build our own market, but those markets have to be built together. So it's a regional market that we are talking about now, over 3 billion people. It's a strong market. It's vibrant. So if we can do this, and it looks like we can, it will help us so that we don't have to export everything outside of the region, but we can exchange and we can cooperate and we can help each other here.
Okay, Mr. Pitsawan, good luck on the discussions and thank you so much for making time for us on your busy day. That's Sirin Pitsawan, ASEAN's Secretary General, joining us on the line from Bali, Indonesia.